Content warning, in this video we will be displaying explicit messages that were sent to a minor, but we'll be giving you another warning before it happens. So, it's been a few months
since
Pigmate Games released our video titled How Roblox is Exploiting Young Game Developers. In it, we shone a light on how Roblox, which is today one of the largest video games in the world, encourages children to make games on its platform only to give them a tiny fraction of the revenue that their games make. We had concerns about the extent to which Roblox is a system that predates on child creativity, and overwhelmingly, you folks shared those concerns.
This seems pretty easy to follow so far. Roblox exploits kids. Allegedly. Roblox exploits kids. I'll say it with my chest. I don't think I need like the first bit of context.
But I'll tell you who else had an interesting reaction to our reporting. Roblox Corporation. You might remember a part in the last video where we talked about a page on Roblox.com that told kids they could make serious cash.
Mm-hmm.
After our video was released, this was silently removed from the platform.
Oh.
But this was just an appetizer
of
what was to come. So with this in mind, we reached out to Roblox again. You see, when we were researching the first video, we emailed them asking for an interview or comment, and they did not respond. But with half a million views,
they're like a billion-dollar company.
We reached out to Roblox to say that we were working on a follow-up, and this time, Roblox's new senior director of corporate communications and public affairs offered to speak to us on the phone to see if we could arrange an interview.
Oh yeah, let's go.
We did not succeed at arranging a straight interview. However, during that call, Roblox told us that our first video contained a number of errors, going as far as to suggest that we take our video off YouTube. Now, we asked Roblox again and again what these errors were, and we never once got a straight answer. Closest we got was Roblox sending us to a link to a blog post from somebody with the online handle EcoScratcher, asking us, do you plan on editing or removing the video based on some of the things the author raises?
Well, it's just a bunch of fucking Twitter links. What is he linking? People sucking Roblox's cock or something? How is that helpful? Didn't he ask them what the errors were? And his response is here, check these Twitter posts from real Evan Pickle. Like, how is that supposed to be helpful? As you can see, Mr. Pickle over here happened to have noticed a little editing error. Your voice was a bit off sync.
Part 1, Roblox's unregulated managers. Part 2, moderation and child safety. Part 3, did you know there's an entire stock market baked into this game's official store in which children are encouraged to gamble real money?
Yeah, let's go!
People reported on this yet? Come to think of it,
because it's great.
We miss it in the first video.
That's how you make a lot of money. You get kids gambling.
Roblox's black markets. So back in the day, Roblox's central proposition was straightforward. Individual kids could play around with tools and make games for other kids and maybe make money. But as Roblox has gotten more players, at the time of this video, it has 47.3 million users every day.
Holy shit.
The most popular games on the platform have been making more and
more money.
Which means there's more competition. Mostly, the popular games are made by whole teams of people who are improving the scripting, modeling, the sound, and are churning out updates to keep people playing.
But you don't need that. I guess this is just more of like a PSA to any hopeful game devs. If you want to just start making money on Roblox, you can make anything. Kids will watch and play anything, even if it's the most dog shit thing ever. Because kids are entertained by anything. So you don't have to put that much effort into it. Just make a lot of them, and then I'm sure you'll make plenty of money doing that. Just keep churning shit out. Not true. Look at YouTube Kids. Any kids content fucking pops off. Because kids will actually watch anything. And look at games. Like, go on Steam, new releases, and no matter how awful the game is, you'll at least see some reviews from some very clearly young players. It's just, you will literally always have an audience if you cater it towards kids. Because kids will actually play or watch anything.
Today, more and more people who want to take their Roblox development career seriously develop marketable skills like animation or programming for Roblox, and then leave the platform to sell their skills in a totally unregulated cluster of virtual communities, mostly Discord servers. Signing contracts, or worse, having no contract at all with bosses who might have no experience in management and might be a child themselves. And Roblox is not...
I like that, like, thought process. like this underground syndicate of developers. They've gone rogue, and it's just a bunch of fucking kids in suits exploiting each other for their Robux. It is crazy, though. I feel like it'd be better if kids weren't creating games for kids. I feel like it'd be better if it was teams doing it, because at least then you'd know as a parent it's at least something of decent quality. Like, if I had a kid, last thing I'd want him doing is wasting his fucking time playing something that my dumb neighbor's kid made. I want him playing something good. Fucking Psychonauts or some shit.
Will they pay my child fairly?
I don't know.
Will they mistreat my child?
I don't know.
Is it safe for my child to do this?
Oh, absolutely.
But if something does happen to my child...
There's simply no way to be sure.
Will you be taking action against those responsible?
No.
I'll tell you who does take action. I'm sorry to keep interrupting. This actually is a pretty interesting topic. There is a community of people who take action against Roblox bad actors. And it's right here on the terminated players list. This is where the Roblox villains live. Forever in infamy, on the wall of shame. We have some of the most heinous players in all of Roblox history, including Greg9 and Greg1999112Sun. And if you go down far enough, you'll find the most dastardly of them all. Wait, where is he? Hold on, I gotta get to the X's. Hold on. Why is he not on here? Where's Sonic the Hedgehog? XX Sonic the Hedgehog? He escaped. That's probably what it was. I got his name wrong. The X's came after. Sonic the fucking Hedgehog. This guy terrorized the streets of Roblox for far too long. Not even the CIA was enough to stop him in his prime. He had to be taken down by other kids in the server. Until one day he just left peacefully. They weren't locked in there with him. He was locked in there with them at the end of it all. God rest his soul. He actually commented on my Roblox video. He actually still goes by this name on his YouTube channel. So, it's a bit disingenuous to say Roblox doesn't do anything when there's bad actors in their community. Because, I mean, look at this. This counts as something. Jim Wool is... Yeah, I haven't seen Jim Wool on these lists yet, but he's probably just too new. He's like the most recent raid boss.
In fact, talking about what your boss did to you on the official Roblox developer forums falls under the category of harassment. And since there's no plan...
Let me read these real quick. Yeah, if you're mistreated by your boss, don't tell Roblox about it. You yourself get banned. Rightfully so. Fucking snitch.
Statements. So we emailed...
Ooh, hold on a second. Hey, Connor. The structure of Roblox is so strange to me because I had an offer of like 20k from a Roblox game developer to have them make games for me to stream. But it was somewhat sketchy and I wasn't sure how involved Roblox themselves were. 20k to stream some Roblox games and you didn't do it, Connor? You deserve to be on the fucking controversial players list on the fucking Roblox wiki. What a deal. You have to play Roblox and get 20k? Are you insane? Unbelievable. But yeah, obviously Roblox themselves isn't involved. It's just some like weird, crusty dudes that develop pretty mediocre experiences. But god damn it, that's what makes Roblox Roblox. Why do people keep saying check Roblox stock? That's a rough day. That's a rough day for Roblox fans everywhere. Oh, that's a rough 5 day. Oh, this is a bad month for Roblox fans everywhere. But it's a good year. We're looking good on the year though. So you know, win some, you lose some.
When talking about problems with Roblox's moderation, it is hard to know where to start. The side of the moderation that makes the best headlines are the games that simply should not be there. Like this Wired article on the fascist role-playing games, or this Rolling Stone article on the trolls who are always coming up with new ways to hide sex games
on
Roblox. To hear Roblox's players tell it, the moderation is infuriating because it simply works when it's not supposed to and doesn't work when it is supposed to. With automated filters offering unfair temporary bans for using words like fat, gay, and pill, while still leaving enough scammers on the platform that the BBC chose to issue a warning.
Hold on, I want to read that. Oh, so it's kind of like the zero tolerance thing. RuneScape kind of has the same thing. If you get scammed, it's basically go fuck yourself. And it's really not like the worst policy in the world to have because it would be so highly exploited otherwise. So I guess like the best thing they could do is have like some kind of, I don't know, like Scrub McGruff crime dog teach you how to avoid scams. Like I don't really know what you're supposed to do. It's just people getting scammed. And if you like come in there to try and like hold their hand like, okay, you got scammed, we'll give you your shit back. Then there's going to be a million other people who pretend they got scammed and it's going to be a whole mess. There's really just not a good solution to that. So I understand Roblox's policy there.
After this channel's last video on Roblox, a number of concerned parties got in touch with us to see if we could force Roblox to act regarding a Roblox developer with a few nicknames, including Dr. Rofatnik and Jaden Shedletsky.
The infamous Rofatnik?
Sarah.
No!
Real name.
I've trusted him for years.
In a Discord server, Doc was 24 and he knew that Sarah was 12.
Not Dr. Rofatnik.
Well, he had mentioned his Roblox fan game, and I was like, hey, I like Roblox too. He was making a Roblox Sonic fan game.
Oh, that sounds about right. Oh, God.
So I asked him about it. God. Next thing I know, I get like 5 pings, and he sends me a bunch of GIFs of it.
Of course
he's
he
sending
was.
Me progress of it already. He was the one who started taking the inappropriate jokes in the DMs first.
But Sarah made friends within these games' community.
So, hold on. So, someone fill me in. I pretend that I know who Rofatnik is. Who is he? Is he on like the actual Roblox team? Like as a moderator or something? Or is he just a developer? Like a random developer making shitty Sonic porn? Okay, so he's not on the actual Roblox team. He's a dev. Got it. Okay. Just not like a Roblox dev, but like a dev of just this game. This weird game. So he's just a random guy not affiliated with Roblox.
It wasn't until 2020 that Sarah's friends were able to convince her that this behavior was not okay and helped her to come forward with evidence of Doc's behavior. However, as anyone who's been following the Me Too movement will know, coming forward like this often has devastating consequences for the victim.
You turned right around and tried ruining his life for attention, and I was like, what the f*** are you talking about?
Jesus.
Doc released a video denying the allegations, going as far as including this audio of the developer still working under him, defending his character.
The DMs that were exchanged between Jaden and the victims were not okay, but Jaden is by no means a pedophile.
He understands the clear dividing line between jokes and serious actions against others.
No fucking way. Yes, this guy clearly understands jokes, such as, I'd fuck you so hard. I mean, that's a knee slapper. I pretty much tell that one to all my cousins and stuff at Thanksgiving, too. I mean, it's just a good joke, I guess, right? Doc, I mean, again, this is Dr. Rofatnik. I mean, that guy's one of the greats. He understands comedy. It is a bit silly to try and, like, assassinate his character like that.
So let me start by apologizing for the things I've said. I know I shouldn't have said those things regardless of the context. Moving forward, I will not have this behavior. While I will not defend myself for the things I said explicitly, I will protect myself from the blatant attempt at character assassination. For as distasteful as the comments I made are, they weren't genuine.
I feel like I'm listening to a man at the bait club.
While working on this piece, we were sent a 40-minute video of Roblox community members harassing a developer who has since left the development team.
Yeah, because you're stupid and you work with a pedophile and he pays you. Of course you're gonna disagree.
Oh, the vigilantes.
They're from money, that honestly. It's more of a convenience.
It's quite something, this video. You're watching a mob of people harangue a young developer for working for an alleged abuser because they feel there's no way.
This is so weird. This is so weird. Surely there's a better way than going into Roblox with a traffic cone and a Halloween costume to confront fucking Patriot Prime. It's so hard to like wrap my head around that this is real. God damn. Now obviously I think Roblox should step in cases like these and arbitrate, like actually get to the bottom of what is real and what is not, or what is just like harassment of someone innocent, if that is the case, I don't think they should put it in the hands of actual kids. Under no means. Kids should not be hunting pedophiles in their own game. Good God. There should be some kind of feature or some kind of team that Roblox has that takes these on a case-by-case basis.
We have a large, expertly trained team with thousands of members dedicated to protecting our users and monitoring 24/7 for inappropriate content.
So it sounds like they have the team.
Developers removed from our platform.
Why doesn't it work?
Policy violations also lose access to monetizing. That's not true. That's what all of these people are trying to tell them again and again. Doc is still publicly leading the development of his Sonic games, as this recent update video from him proves. Doc's ban did nothing. He's still making money for Roblox and paying developers to come and work under him.
You're probably asking, what's up with the rest of SEO? Where is it at?
I wasn't asking that.
We've been making some stellar progress as of right now, and we actually have a bunch of things.
But if we look at this video published on his channel in April of this year...
I can actually just hear the Dorito dust on that guy's fingers. My God.
And his team, including this bit.
He has the voice of a creepy guy.
Steadily regaining our footing.
What you're looking at here are collectible cosmetics that Roblox either sells a limited number of or sells for a limited time.
This is pretty fucking interesting.
Most recently as tie-ins with brands like Vans, the YouTuber KSI, or Swedish pop star Zara Larsson. And once this initial sale period is over, the only way that kids can get them is either by swapping items with other Roblox users or buying them direct from other
users. So they have
users.
Basically what
TF2
of
Roblox
has
economy is kids trying
CSGO.
To look cool in front of other kids, these items immediately
they've got some gambling.
Skyrocket in
value. Let's go.
$5 or $10
a market
that Roblox sells them. But the important part here is that Roblox always takes a 30% cut from any sale that on its platform. So the more absurdly
30?
Overpriced these items get, and
also you only get a 23% cut from your game while Roblox takes the rest. So even as a developer, oh, that's fucking crazy. Man, Roblox has got it figured out. So you take you only keep 23% of your game's profit as a developer, and if you're selling items, you get 70, so you do get the lion's share there, of course, but a 30% cut to Roblox on that is an absurdly high amount. What does Valve take? Do they even take a percent? It's been a long time since I traded items. What does Valve do? Okay, it looks like 5% of the market and 30% for games. I mean, I just did a really quick search, but it looks like Valve takes 30% from games and 5% from items on their stores. Ooh, that's a lot. 5% is fine on the market side, but 30% from the games, I didn't know it was that big. 30% is industry standard, is it? I guess, I mean, the benefit of being on Steam is it's the biggest platform for PC. So I guess they, like, earn that percentage. But I guess you could argue the same for Roblox. Like, if you're a developer and you're making a Roblox game, it can't be anywhere but Roblox. I don't know, it still seems like a lot.
When Jack was 13, he managed the impressive feat of making a hit Roblox game. He called it Secret Pet Hatching Simulator, which made him 200,000 Robux.
Oh my God, he's a billionaire.
In a heartbeat, he'd spent it.
It was really stupid back then, but like I spent it on stuff in the catalog instead of devexing it into real money, which I really regret now. I spent like half of it and bought like two faces and a hat. And then after the other 100,000 finished
pretty
pending
good.
And I got it in my account, I wanted this bigger item. It was called the Silver King of the Night.
Why is Roblox selling to children items that cost like hundreds of Australian dollars?
What do you mean, why?
It's pretty mind-boggling.
It's obvious
like,
why.
I never spend that much money in real life.
After Jack had bought these items, a Roblox developer that he'd been talking to for a couple of months that he thought was his friend sent Jack a file that Jack thought was an asset to help with Jack's next game.
Oh my God!
I downloaded this file off the Roblox website.
He keylogged
it. Contained a cookie. You can get into their account just by having the cookie. He sold the limited items pretty cheaply and made a quick, like I think it was like 50k after he sold them. I hate myself because of it, because like with that money, I could have made like my parents proud.
Jack,
it's so fucking sad. Poor guy.
In Roblox Studio, there's something called the toolbox where like you can get assets made by other people and use them for your own game. And then the game got banned because I wasn't allowed to use something that Roblox had provided to me.
Some stranger, what? It turned out, had harvested resources from someone else's game and uploaded them to the toolbox illegally. Which meant Jack was using them illegally, even though he'd been provided them by official Roblox channels, and his game, his work, his income was dead.
God damn!
Jack's learning Unity now.
Jack got slapped.
This selling collectibles to kids, Roblox has created and continues to support a stock market for users to gamble
Let's
on
go.
Their children's platform, with Roblox continuing to take a
That's the future, baby.
Every time they're sold between players. This is a breathtaking...
Damn, look at the price of that bitch down there. The Crimson Wraith, or Crimson Wrath, the Red Wrath. $69.69.69. So that's about, what, $3,000? Roughly $3,000? Dude, well, the white sparkle, of course it's a fedora. The white spark, this is probably one of Doc Robo Fat Man. What was it? Robo Fat Nick? Probably one of his custom items. The $1.4 million fedora, Robux fedora. So that's going to be 8,000, right around 8,000. Oh, you're right. There's a 9 million. I didn't see it with the captions. There's 9 million Robux Magna Spectro Inspectors. What the fuck is this? Little Dexter's Lab goggles? Whoever owns this owns Roblox right now. Oh, I want to take a peek at those bad boys. Let me go to the Roblox stocks. It's a limited face accessory. It was published in the Avatar Shop by Roblox in 2010. It could have been purchased for 500 Robux and only 66 were sold. No! Imagine one man has all 66. He'll be the next Warren Buffett, the ultimate Roblox investor. Can I see the owners? Is it like an NFT? Can I see who owns all of these? Is this it? This is it? Oh my god, I can actually see who has them. This is actual NFTs. This is fucking nuts. All right, so Roblox themselves has one. You fucking know one of those devs is going to sell this at some point just for a little quick buck on an alt account or something. Thanks to Tier 1 Shibata and the recent popcorn. Totally Not Shed's got two. This guy's about to be a fucking millionaire. Oh, so many of the... Oh my god, so many of these accounts are terminated. What a shame. I already know I'm going to see Sonic the Hedgehog's name in here. The Magna Spectre Inspectors are worth $31,500. Not Robux, dollars. And the very first owner, according to this, seems to be reverse racist. Man, those Magna Spectre Inspector gadgets or whatever the fuck, they went to a loving household. Totally Not Shed's got two. I don't know what he's waiting for. I can't imagine there's a better time to sell. The hype here on Roblox is reached, I think, its peak. I can't imagine it gets more popular. Now it's only down from here. Totally Not Shed. I'll advise you on how to navigate this. I'll do what Roblox does. I'll take like a 23% commission and I'll help you sell those. Let's get this cooking, Shed. Because right now you're squatting on gold. There is no reason to hold any longer. Diamond hands is a curse, not a blessing.
No warning anywhere on this page about how much you might lose and no upper limit of how much you can spend.
Oh, of course not. We want them spending a ton.
Thousand, or a few tens of thousands. There are items here for you to
What the fuck is that? 618 million Robux? That's $10 billion. What? What was it? The red banana of what? Red bandana of SQL injection. Of course, yeah, Roblox obviously has one. Oh my god, they must be so mad that their accounts are terminated with one of these on it. Oh my god, they have to be fucking fuming. This has to be the most oh my god, they've all been purged. This might be a conspiracy. Maybe it's so expensive Roblox bans these accounts because it's too powerful. It's $2 million USD. 618 million Robux. I don't want to do the calculations in my head, but it's definitely over a million. Oh my god. And some of these kids have it. Why won't you sell it? If someone's going to buy this, Lib, you've got to dump it now. That is life-changing money. And you, Luke. Don't think I don't see you down here, you fucking idiot. Try and dump it. ASAP. This has to be the most expensive item in Roblox. Let me see. I don't know who's going to fucking buy it, but you've got to try. You've got to fucking try. If you have this, you have to try. Look at NFTs. Who is buying pictures of fucking Chakra the Invincible smoking a cigarette, right? But you have people bidding $100,000 on it. This is a new item. This is only 3 years old. Oh, it was given exclusively to Ultra Goat. Oh. So that, all right, I see. So this is kind of like Tyler the Great Warrior in Yu-Gi-Oh! It was a card that Konami made for a kid that was struggling with a disease, and it is listed as one of the most valuable cards ever. So it's kind of like that for Roblox. I see. Okay.
Yo, what is up, guys? It's your boy Kevy here.
Just show me how much it sold for.
Penis, you'll never see him coming. So as you guys can see, Ultrago is no longer the owner of this item. He actually traded the one-of-one copy, his special hat, to UC Unknown. He gave a sub-Arctic Commando, Classic Fedora, Ultra Commando, and in return, he received the Dominus Infernus.
He traded an item valued at $3 million real-world dollars for in-game items. Fuck, that's sad. Oh, God. Oh, that's sad. Yeah, I mean, this all ties back to this. It is a horrible idea to let kids have something that valuable. Oh, fuck, that's sad. That is actual life-changing money. Again, you might not sell it for $3 million, but you will sell it to one of these crazed fucking collectors for at least a big chunk. In a game like Roblox, I have a one-of-one in a fucking thriving market, apparently. You would have made a ton. Oh, God, that's sad. But hats off to this guy who just gave up a, what is this? An Easter egg with an arrow pointing out of it? Whatever the fuck this is, I don't know what it is. Hats off to him for trading this for the Ultra Commando. Hey, that guy, he's going places. This is the art of the deal right here. I hope his parents never see what that item was worth. Oh, man. All right, back to the... We got real sidetracked. We got way off course. This has been wild.
And a click, and my money's gone. There is a reason that societies do not allow children to gamble.
I see it now.
To have a firm understanding of
now money, I get it.
Of risk, of addiction. Most adults I know don't have a firm understanding of all three because gambling and investing are both seen as adult.
Are you telling me that there's a Roblox slot streamers?
Kids want to act like adults. Oh my. Roblox should be warning.
This is amazing.
Collectibles.
He's recent JRM and London.
As anyone who has tried pirating anything ever will know, illegal websites are not safe places for kids to end up. There's malware, credit card phishing, scams, hidden fees. These websites will make kids watch videos or fill out forms, to say nothing of the fact that kids have to get legally creative when it comes to how to put their money.
Imagine the IRS just throws all these kids in the slammer.
These websites exist. What is surprising is how
You visited Roblox Black Market.
How the most popular ones have been up and
running. Why didn't you pay your tax on
it? For years. We were told that we weren't being objective, while this company refused to even admit the existence of the collectible stock market that they created, of the underground black market website that they allowed to exist. They didn't say anything to us about this questionable reality of kids working underneath other kids.
So that's interesting. Does what does Roblox say about the stock market? Because it's inarguable. It is a stock market they've created in their items and their collectibles. What do they say about it? Thanks to the Resub Mountains. Nothing? Not a damn... How is there so much hoopla about loot boxes in games, but no one talks about that? I didn't realize that was a thing. I feel like that would be a much bigger topic of discussion, especially since most kids use their parents' credit card to buy those items. I feel like most of them are aware of it. Why isn't it like an issue? I didn't realize it was this thing. That's exactly why. Well, it's because I don't play Roblox. If I was a parent and my money was being siphoned into fucking hats on the Roblox store, I'd notice it. These kids don't have their own money to spend, obviously. Well, I guess maybe they do, since they're working for developers on Roblox. So I guess maybe that's possible. I don't really know. I just feel like Roblox being the most profitable game, one of the most profitable games in the world right now, most people would have immediately put that stock market in their crosshairs. but I haven't heard shit. I had no clue. It's user curated, so technically people don't freak out because it's not Roblox directly. But Roblox takes, what was it, 30%? 30% of a sale? So they are directly involved in it. Like, they make a lot of money off it. This was a really good video. I think they did a great job with the whole thing. So I saw this in the chat. I have a different opinion. I think in-game stock market is good because it teaches kids about the economy. Yeah, but it shouldn't come at the expense of, like, real money. If you want to teach kids about the stock market, give them not real assets. Sure, teaching kids about the stock market is great. But not when it's... Like, we just watched a kid who had a one-of-one item valued at $3 million give it away for in-game items. That's not really teaching them anything valuable. That's something that they'd look back on in the future and be like, oh my god. Like, you can teach kids these things without it coming at the expense of actual money and their well-being. God, now I want to own all those fucking Roblox items. I'll be the kingpin. You want your Dominus... Fuck, was it the Dominus... Impossibly Hot... Hat? What the fuck? What? Oh my god, I don't remember any of these stupid names. Well, you have to go through me. For your parents' money.